Entertaining a newborn baby was by far more difficult than I had ever imagined. Just any babies in general. First of all, babies sleep for quite some time, anywhere between 15 hours to 20 hours in a day. And in that short period that they're awake, it's so easy to get carried away cooing and looking at them. You know, they are so cute, they're so adorable. I spent most of my time just staring at Levi, taking pictures and videos. Obsessive amounts of pictures and videos, by the way. But at the back of my mind, I did have this nagging feeling that I should be proactively doing something for his development. When he was in the newborn stage between 0 to 3 months, it was probably slightly easier because his wake window was much, much shorter. So during that short period of time that he was awake, I did a little bit of tummy time here and there and a bit of talking and, you know, carrying him a little bit, and that was it. But as he grew and as he became a lot more alert, I started worrying. It's probably the first child syndrome, it's probably the pandemic, and now we can't really go out freely, we can't go to anyone's houses, no one can come and visit us easily, we can't even go out to the shops without having to wear a mask, even in church we need to wear masks. I mean, I as an adult find it difficult to recognize people with masks. How much more can a young baby manage it? It's just everything put together ultimately. I needed to know what to do with Levi to entertain him so that neither of us will get bored, and I wanted to make sure I was doing something for his development and also for my own well-being. I knew there was a lot of support for mothers, but I just didn't know how to access it because of the pandemic. It made it a little bit more difficult because everything which should have been an open group became by invitation only, and I just didn't know how to access that. But with a lot of Googling and a lot of searching and some conversation with some friends who live nearby and locally, I found quite a few things actually. So long story short, let me list out all of these things for you. And I will, as always, leave timestamp because there are a few different categories. If you click on the description box below, you will be able to see the timestamps. Activities at home can be anything like singing, reading to the baby, tummy time, playing with their rattle, playing with their teething toys, and even looking at different things in the house. I was really, really surprised by the amount of things that Levi found interesting in the house. We are so used to everything around us, you know, our kitchen, our bedroom, our living room, office room, whatever it is. Everything is so normal for us because we've always seen that. But for babies, it's all brand new. I was surprised one day when I was carrying Levi in the kitchen. He was so interested looking at all of the spice jars and racks and a lot of bottles and cans that I had in the kitchen. That's when I realized that I need to actually take the initiative and make an effort to show him everything and explain what it is. It's not like he's going to understand everything immediately, but that will add on to his vocabulary and that will add on to the new things that he sees every day so that he can familiarize himself with everything around the house. Baby sensory classes are designed to help babies with their developments, and as the name suggests, it's a sensory development especially. It's for their social and their physical developments before they go to preschool. It's designed to provoke baby senses, and these classes are usually very, very structured, and it runs for about anywhere between 30 minutes to 45 minutes, and it involves their hearing, their sight, smell, touch, and emotion. Some baby sensory classes will also give you ideas for creative play at home, some massaging for babies, some visual development, and musical movement. Babies enjoy music and singing, so baby sensory classes are usually very, very musical. It's where a lot of other parents will come with similar age babies, so it's kind of a social group for your baby and for yourself as a parent also. You can go out and meet people, and you can replicate a lot of those activities at home. I was a little bit late to this baby sensory classes. By the time I realized, everything was fully booked out and I didn't have anything at all. And then eventually I found something when Levi was 4.5 months old. I will link up that video for you so you can have a feel of how it looks like. And most of these baby sensory classes are paid for unless it's run by your church or some sort of charity organization is running it. You can do a quick Google search to find if there are any baby sensory classes around you. Everything around me was paid for. If you do find something free, then good for you. Online baby sensory classes are very, very similar to the baby sensory classes that I just spoke about, except that this is online and not in person. It could either be because they're not able to meet in person, as they couldn't comply with the pandemic requirements and regulations, or it could be a free session online. There's a few that I found online, and one in particular that I really want to recommend. It's from Sophie Pickles. She is so good. I've not seen all of her videos, but she's done quite a lot of baby sensory classes, and she does one every week on her YouTube channel. So you have a lot of variety to choose from. She has different activities each week. It's about 20 minutes to 40 minutes, and there are different rhymes that she does, different activities. And she explains everything to you. She explains why you need to do certain signs, or you know, what improvement it will give for the child to do certain actions. And if there are any action songs, then she will show you the actions and explain that to you also. I found that really useful to play with Levi, to sing along some nursery rhymes with him, or even to teach him some actions. She's also done some baby sign languages. If you are interested in teaching that to your babies, then you could try and follow that through. If you're following these videos, I would recommend that you watch these videos ahead of time and be prepared to play or to sing that to your baby instead of watching that video with your baby, because babies will enjoy looking at your face more than looking at a TV screen or a computer screen. Breastfeeding support group is very, very common everywhere. Whichever area you live in, whichever country you live in, there will always be some sort of breastfeeding support group around you. The one that I went to was recommended to me by my health visitor. They were closed for quite some time, so they were not meeting in person because of the pandemic, but there was always support online via a Facebook group. I attended this breastfeeding support group in person the other day. It's just an open group. This is a very casual group where mothers bring their young babies along and a lactation consultant will be present, and there will also be some other volunteers there. So you can either chat with the lactation consultant, or you can speak to the volunteers, or you can just speak to other mothers, you know. It's just to meet someone locally. You can meet other mothers locally, or you have the support if you needed to, if you're struggling with breastfeeding or you have some specific questions that you want to ask an expert, they are always available for you to speak to them. This breastfeeding support group is for the benefit of mothers as well as it is for the babies. Your babies may not be getting any one-to-one during this, but they are meeting so many other babies, they're meeting so many other people, they are meeting in an entirely different location and environment, all of those things. Levi left this group when I took him to it. He just enjoyed looking at other people, and he was so excited to see so many other babies around about his age. Baby Hub is very, very similar to the breastfeeding group, except that it's not necessarily for mothers who are breastfeeding only. It's just for everyone, and with this one, there will be families present, so mothers and fathers sometimes bring in their babies, a lot of people, and the idea is always the same. It's to meet groups who are local to you, other families and other friends, and it's to meet some experts. There will be the health visitor and a community nurse also. One of them were there, and with the Baby Hub, you can also weigh your baby. If you have any specific questions, you can speak to them and they will be able to guide you through. Again, it was my health visitor who recommended me to this group. So if you do not know about all of these things, you can speak to your health visitor, or you can even speak to your doctor and they will be able to recommend anything nearby or around you. I wish I had known about this library much, much earlier. But still, it's better late than never. One of my friends told me about this local library. I went and registered with them. Once you register at the library, you can borrow up till 20 books for your baby, and you can keep it for 3 weeks. This library that I've registered at also has an app online. So if I wanted to renew any of my books, if I couldn't go to the library to return it or to exchange it, I could just renew it on the app. It was as easy as that. And with this library, you can borrow so many books that you don't even have to buy. Because I didn't know about this library, I ended up buying so many hardboard books for Levi, the ones for babies and the ones that can flip through to entertain babies. Those kind of books, I feel, is not really worth your investment at all. It's no point in you spending that much money. you could just borrow from the local library. And my library here also does this thing called Rhyme Time. There is an expert there, an experienced teacher sort of a thing, who will sit there and teach some nursery rhymes. So sing some rhymes with the babies, and the parents can learn that also, and then go back and sing that with the babies. I can't tell you enough how good this group has been for me. My church runs a mother's group every alternate weeks in different mother's houses each time. It's a very informal group, somewhat like a cell group where we discuss the Bible, where we discuss the sermon from Sunday, but it's very, very informal. The first time I went, I was a little bit taken aback, as in, I didn't really know what to expect. I was a bit apprehensive. I was like, I don't think I know everyone there, and I don't know what they're going to be talking about, how I'm going to interact with everyone, how I'm going to manage Levi on my own in front of everyone else. I was probably kind of worried about judgment because everyone else have had babies before me, and I was the youngest one with a baby there, you know, literally. At the time of filming this, I've only been to that group twice so far, and both the times I had my reservations. The first time it was in my friend's house, who's just 5 minutes down the road from me, and I had so many doubts about it. I was worried to drive on my own with Levi. I was worried about who was going to be coming there, whether I would know them or not, what they were going to be talking about, whether I would feel welcomed or whether I would feel out of place. And the second time, it was in someone's house that I've never met before. I didn't even know. 5 minutes before leaving home the second time, I wanted to, you know, cancel on them, but I thought I'll just give it a go. But I just cannot tell you enough how good it has been for me. Such a casual chat. So many mothers were there. It's like everyone's just randomly talking about their children, talking about everything under the sun, basically. Not necessarily a place where you go specifically to ask questions, just a place for you to socialize with some other people. And because it's mothers, it's someone who understands what you're going through. So even if you don't have to exactly say what you need, they know what you need. And especially because it's run by the church, it's like you have that automatic spiritual covering, that automatic caring, a concern that comes. At the end of both the meetings I went to, I felt so refreshed, and Levi being Levi, he was so excited to see other people. He was so excited to see children and other adults without any masks. It was just really nice. He couldn't really play with them, but it was so sweet of other kids to bring toys to him, wanting to play with him, and he was just smiling at everyone, you know? It's so important to find a group with like-minded people. It took me a good 8 weeks to muster up enough courage to be able to go out. The first outing I did was to church, and that was only 2 hours. I actually recovered 6 weeks after the labor, but I just wasn't ready to go out and meet people. Different people recover at different stages, and different people are able to go out and resume their normal life at different stages. If you are in the same boat as I was in, don't worry about it at all. You take however long you need to. But it's really important that you're able to meet other people and go out to groups. If you're not aware of any groups around you, then speak to someone. Speak to your doctor, speak to your health visitor, speak to your friends, speak to your family. Do a lot of searching on Google to find local groups. If there are days when you feel like you want to be in your pajama all day and just stay at home and not go out at all, by all means, do it if you need to. I've had Levi for 6 months now, and I still have days where I just want to be in my pajama and I don't want to go out, I don't want to see anyone at all. But then there are also days where I am buzzing and full of energy and I just want to go out and meet people and do whatever activity I can with Levi. I hope you found all of these helpful and you know where to turn to if you needed any help. But whatever you do, remember what works for your family does not necessarily work for someone else's family. So don't expect yourself to be in the same pace as another person or another family member. And remember that you need to take time for yourself. You have to take care of yourself in order to be able to take care of your child and your family. Enjoy the journey as much as you can. Once it's gone, it's gone. Sending you and your baby a lot of love. You take care, and I will see you again next week, same time, same place. Be sure to subscribe so that you're notified whenever I upload videos every week. And also, share this video with your friends and like it. I never ask for this to be shared at all, but a lot of my videos are meant to be for a lot of families and friends. So if you know someone who could benefit from my videos, then share it with them.